We're at the beginning of a new wave of research.
Let's make bug A go, what would you say, down one square and right one square. So you see, what we'll get is the program going through these lines.
A consulting graphic artist and a Bell Laboratory scientist are collaborating on an idea for an experimental computer-made movie.
Come out of it, you know, and right, this idea of you being able to program something so we know what it's supposed to do. And what I get a great deal of response out of is you don't know what it's exactly going to do in terms of images.
It's interesting to me that you say the unexpected things that happen.
Yeah.
Because in a sense, the computer has done exactly what you told it to do, right?
Under computer control now, the taped information is converted into rapidly moving pictures made up of a fine mosaic of points of varying light intensity. A synchronized movie camera automatically photographs the fast-moving images as they are plotted and drawn on the face of a cathode ray tube.
Out to this technology. I want to incorporate this technology into my art and have the two mixed together. For instance, what spellbinds me as an idea is that I'll be able to sit someplace in a railroad station and write a movie, or maybe even pick up a telephone eventually and write a movie.
Besides creating unique visual effects, computer movies can be used to show phenomena we can't directly see. This film describes the motion of a communication satellite. By studying it, scientists can obtain new insight into the satellite's stabilizing system. Only a man orbiting alongside could observe it the same way. The shape and texture of perceived objects are studies that look deep into the future of communications. When we learn to separate the relevant from irrelevant in visual information, we'll be on the way to sending three-dimensional color picture messages over ordinary telephone lines. Musical score accompanying this film was composed on a computer that can produce nearly endless variations of sounds.
Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer to.
Programming the score is like composing for conventional musical instruments, except that notes are replaced by numbers. The computer converts these numbers into impulses that cause sound waves to come directly from a loudspeaker. Human speech, seemingly so simple, is a very complicated process no one fully understands.
To be or not to be? That is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing end them, to die, to sleep.
The art of computer graphics is only in its infancy. Yet it is already stimulating creative thought in far-out areas where research is likely to get complex and unwieldy. It offers not only the means to quicken the pace of discovery, but an ideal way of communicating what we may discover.